So I'm back here with my buddy Liam, and we're going to be talking about Chapter 4 in the Hargreaves Tax. And that concerns infotainment, as we call it today, which is the idea that journalism should not only be informative, but in order to catch the attention of audiences, needs to be entertaining as well, hence the hybrid word infotainment, which can be used to describe most content, whether in print, on broadcast, or online today, and when we're talking about journalism. Not every story will be an item of infotainment, but when you look at the overall dimensions of a news entity or item, a news publication or outlet, you'll find that infotainment is probably its defining characteristic. People equate infotainment with sensationalism, and usually sensationalism is equated with negative, bad journalism. But as Hargreaves talks about, and as I also mentioned in my PowerPoint on the subject, that there are potential positives to the practice of the use of sensationalism. For one thing, it democratizes the audience. It widens the audience for significant and serious news, as well as for the more ephemeral and trivial. It provides, at least some sociologist figures it provides, Liam may disagree, but provides catharsis, that is, antisocial feelings that are pent up, given the way we live, this highly technological, estranged mass culture, where we're really not allowed to express all the things we suffer and experience. That this provides a kind of symbolic release. And it serves, weirdly enough, in all these discussions of sex and violence and scandal, it serves as a forum for moral and lifestyle choices. And not insignificantly, it adds voices, multiplies the voices in a kind of version of the open marketplace of ideas that we met way back when we were looking at libertarian theory. It kind of multiplies the voices that are available. And these voices in tabloid journalism sometimes come from the lower depths or from the margins of society, and therefore gives us a perspective that is not generally hospitable it's not generally invited in establishment circles. Are there negatives? Absolutely, there may well be negatives. Infotainment may end up being so rampant that it swamps everything else. And it may become so. He does actually have an arm. Here it is. It may condition people to be to the trivial and the transitory, to give them little patience for anything that they have to really focus on long term and deliberately and systematically contemplate or analyze. Another thing about sensationalism, this goes, and it's true of the sensationalism that existed back in the days, even of the penny papers, when there was a thing called the Moon Hoax, where the New York Sun, invented a story about an astronomer in England seeing through a telescope creatures living on the moon, and ran a series of really pseudo interviews with this scientist, presented in kind of highfalutin academic language, that convinced some of the some of their readers. In the age of yellow journals, we saw that stunts were performed, such as Nellie Bly racing around the world in 80 days. Today, we have somewhat similar. Sean Penn interviewing El Chapo, the Mexican drug kingpin, creating what are called pseudo-events, events that are created by the media so they can be covered by the media. A kind of false excitement. That, incidentally, is our dog, Dewey, a Bichon Poodle mix, who just told me I'm done.